Hi everyone, it's John
and Ben,
and we're back with another MLP review, and today we're taking a look at a Toys R Us exclusive. This is from Toys R Us's new series, The Elements of Friendship.
This is the Sparkle Friends collection. Ooh, and right here, special edition Gilda the Griffin and Manticore.
I guess we'll have to get them out of the package. I don't know what's so special about them.
I don't know. We'll find out.
They look identical to the old ones.
There's Gilda, and there's Manticore. So here's the back of the package, and we have Gilda and Rainbow Dash up here in the clouds.
We have Applejack and Flim Skim, as he's known in the toys.
I can't get over that. There's Rarity and Button Bell.
Cranky Doodle and Pinkie Pie.
Fluttershy and Manticore.
And Trixie Lulamoon and Twilight. So this set pairs up each of the main six, who are all like sparkly, with like one of their adversaries.
Yes. Can't really say enemies because that doesn't work on this show.
And up here on this scroll, this letter to Princess Celestia, they learn lessons in friendship together.
It says it includes 12 figures and shirt. only one of them is wearing a shirt. I'll give you a hint. It's that one right there.
Now, a lot of these, or actually all of these, are going to look familiar if you're a longtime minifigure collector.
None of these are new sculpts of anything. Different paint jobs, but the same sculpt.
But what makes this set so special is, in the eyes of Toys R Us, I should say, is that the main six are all glittery. Some of them have a lot more glitter applied than others, but we'll take a closer look at that in a second.
Yeah, we'll look at that in person, because, What I can't wait to see is how they did the paint job for these. Like, Twilight, you can tell, is painted all purple with a little bit of pink. You know, and Pinkie Pie is all pink with a little bit of different pink.
And Rarity is all white with just some purple stripes in her hair.
So they painted their manes the same as their bodies, which is kind of weird. But I want to take them out of the package before I say too much about them.
Now, this set currently is $25 at Toys R Us. And we'll let you be the judge if that's too much or not. If we weren't doing YouTube reviews of these,
we wouldn't have bought them.
We probably would have waited until it went on sale. You gotta be honest with you.
Yeah.
Right? Because these are all repeats of characters we've seen before.
I think our plastic shell was on the ground at some point during manufacturing. Look how dirty it is.
If you look close in the backgrounds, the characters, like Twilight and Trixie, were up against here, and Pinky and Cranky Doodle here. So they all had corresponding ones, like Rainbow Dash and Cloudsville.
Well, that is cool packaging. I'll give them that.
Cloudsdale, I know the difference.
Oh, I didn't even...
We're going to get comments on that one.
I wasn't even paying attention to you.
All right, well, let's pop some of these out. Let's start with Rarity.
That was the closest one to me.
Are you going to get glitter on your fingers?
Yep.
I have to admit, I do like the glittery Rarity in the light.
Rarity looks really good being glitterized, but I just can't get over the paint job where her hair is white.
She looks like a piece of candy.
She does. She looks like ribbon candy for hair.
And Rarity is joined by Button Bell. Button Bell is also known as Suri Polymer on the show. These figures are really in there. They're not going to bounce out of these shells.
Mm-mm.
All right, we've busted them all out now. And now, Ben put these up next. We have Twilight Sparkle Princess Alicorn Twilight Sparkle.
She does have her crown, even though you can't really tell because it blends
in. Yeah, I was about to point out that her crown is painted purple, just like the rest of her. She seems a lot lighter purple than usual.
Yeah, this is very strange. I don't think I like this paint job at all on Twilight. She looks funny.
And Twilight is joined by the great and powerful Trixie Lulamoon, who we've seen in blind bag form many times before.
And next up we have Rainbow Dash with Gilda.
And Rainbow Dash has like an excessive amount of glitter on her. She looks like a kindergartner's art project.
Yeah, I have to say that the Rainbow Dash glitter job is horrible.
Glitter bomb.
I think it would be okay if it was her whole body. Like, I know all of them, they have a patch around their cutie mark that isn't glittered, and they have a patch around their eyes that isn't glittered, but the blue glitter is so thick and so dark that the patches of no glitter really, really stand out, and this just looks horrendous. I probably could have glitterized my own Rainbow Dash better than that with a glitter marker.
Next up, we have what the package is calling the Special Edition Gilda, but to my eye, anyway, she doesn't look any different than when Gilda originally came out in that 3-pack.
Yeah. We don't have our Gilda right now. We're in the middle of moving, so we're not really sure where she is.
We can't compare our two Gildas side by side.
But we do have the glittery, translucent one that we have gotten from a blind bag. And they look quite similar, other than the glitter, obviously.
But I think the regular colored version was the same as this, but if not, let us know down in the comments if there's any difference that you can see.
Yeah. Don't bother me, Pinky! Why? You're fun!
So next up, we have the Pinkie Pie minifigure and the Cranky Doodle Donkey minifigure. The Cranky Doodle figure came from the Party Wagon set.
Mm-hmm. But he doesn't have any accessories.
No, he doesn't have his little party hat or wagon or anything.
This is like when he first shows up to town, and he's like walking around, and Pinky's like, hi, hi!
I still wish they gave him removable hair.
That would be awesome.
I know we said that when we originally reviewed him.
Mm-hmm. I can't believe they didn't do that for this set. Come on!
And of course, we have Glittery Pinkie Pie, who looks like the 8,700 other Pinkie Pies, except has a little glitter on her.
And her hair is mostly the same color as her body.
The glitter's not too bad on this Pinkie Pie.
No, I mean, there's still the break, you know, where the other ink had to be put onto the body, you know, for her eyes and the cutie mark and stuff. But this one doesn't look quite as bad. This side looks really good, actually. Just make it look like she's talking to him and you can't see her face, and everything will be great.
Yay!
Next up, we have the minifigure of Fluttershy and what the package calls the Special Edition Manticore. But once again, this Manticore looks exactly the same as when he originally came out in the, I think it was the Elements of Harmony set. It's one that came with the sea serpent.
Yeah.
And I think it was the first time we got Fluttershy mm-hmm. with her corrected hair.
Yeah. He looks the same to me. I mean, I don't see anything obvious that is different.
I guess that set's a little harder to find than it used to be. Mm. So maybe if you really want the Manticore with the little thorn stuck in his paw, I guess this is a way you could do it. Interesting side note, when this figure was originally released in that set, his name on the package was Manny Roar, but in this set, he's just called Manticore, so there you go, a little trivia.
And here is little Fluttershy, and she has blonde hair to go with her yellow body. She looks funny with a blonde mane, little yellow mane, yellow body. The glitter doesn't look too bad on her either because it's light enough. I think it looks pretty good. I like the little streaks of pink, though. Kind of reminds her of me.
And finally, we complete the main six with minifigure Applejack and one of the Flim Flam brothers. We have Flim Skim, as the package calls him. And Flim here originally came with the Cider Squeezy mm-hmm. playset.
And he had a hat. You can remove his shirt, just like with the Cider Squeezy set.
But they didn't throw in his hat.
Nope. No hat. Give me all your apples, see?
I'm one of the Flim Flam brothers.
He even looks like he's singing into a microphone because he has his hoof up. Like he's singing into it like...
Of course, if you have seen the Cider Squeezy set, he came with a little podium, which is mm-hmm. why he's posed this way.
Yep. Because he is talking.
A lot of recycling went into this Toys R Us yes. set. And we have, it looks like Applejack got into the cinnamon. Like Apple Cinnamon Jack.
She was just tossed in there. This is how she came out. She got a little honey on her first, and she came out like this.
I think she's tied with Rainbow Dash for most glitter.
Yeah.
She kind of overdid it with the glitter.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm not going to be mean about this one because I was already bad enough with Rainbow Dash. So I'm just going to, you know, there she is. She would not go out in public looking like this.
to be like, I look ridiculous.
Yeah, I look ridiculous.
I guess if I had to recommend this set to anybody, it would probably be if you're just starting out collecting the minifigures.
Mm-hmm.
If you've been collecting like us since the beginning,
it'd be a little redundant.
Yeah, everybody is pretty much a repeat, except for the sparkly main six.
Unless you're a collector who wants to have, like, every variation of them.
Or wants to keep it in the box.
Yeah, yeah.
And I do appreciate the thought that went into the set. Everybody is paired with an appropriate character.
Yeah, that was nice.
It wasn't like Applejack and, Sea Swirl or some,
right.
some random pony.
Yeah.
So in that regard, I do appreciate there was a little thought, but it's hard to get like super psyched about this set when there's like everybody is just, like we've been saying over and over again, this originally came from here, and this guy came from this set.
Yeah.
A lot of recycling, but we knew that going in.
And the one thing that it does have going for it is you get 12 ponies, you know, all in one package. And it's probably just a little bit under what you would spend individually for a pony in a blind bag. So, you might be saving a couple pennies on that too, depending on where you buy your blind bags.
And I'm sure as we get closer to the holidays that there will be sales at Toys R Us.
Oh yeah, there always are.
Let us know what you guys think of this Elements of Friendship set down in the comments. And if you like this video, be sure to subscribe to our channel.
And like and comment.
And you can also follow us on Instagram,
Facebook,
Twitter,
and Snapchat.
We'll see you next time, everybody.
Bye.